My name is Alex van den Heffer, and I have worked with Renius and Klongo for the past 23 years. Together, we bring to you the power of relationships.
The relationship between my thumb and my forefinger allows me to pick up the seed over here and to access its potential. My thumb alone cannot do it, and my forefinger won't pick it up, but together makes it a relatively simple task. Renius and I were thrown together to become ranger and tracker. And I think the head ranger of the time assigned me to the most experienced tracker to try and offset this imbalance of inexperience. And I realized at some point in those early phases that if I had any remote chance of becoming a successful game ranger, I needed to start building a rapport, a relationship with this man I'd been assigned to work with. This leopard was very interesting. On most days, she'd virtually brush herself up against the vehicles. She was totally calm and accepting. Guests could take as many pictures as they wanted to, no problem. And then on other days, this leopard would just stare and growl, and then you knew trouble was coming. This leopard was beautiful and dangerous, all at the same time. A little bit like an ex-girlfriend I once had. If Renius found fresh tracks, Renius had not only seen those tracks at driving at 30 or 40 kilometers an hour, he'd identified that it was a leopard, it was a female, and which female it was. We kept going, and as we got further and further down the Donga, I noticed he was getting slower and slower until eventually he stopped, and he knelt down again, and he drew another circle in the sand like this, and he said to me, "These tracks have walked now, 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 now." He said, "Be careful, this animal is close by, and look out." We got to an area where there were a few logs that had been washed down from the previous year's floods. I put my foot on the one log, I hesitated, and as I put my foot down, I just heard this low growl, and this leopard exploded down the bushes. I could not tell a teeth from a tail, from side to side. Now I try to back up, and I get caught in the log. My rifle gets flung out of reach. This animal screams straight up to me and slams with her paw, one paw on the log. I just tripped over. Sand hits me in the shins. She's right over me. I can still her breath. He says, "Majomba, Yima, wait." I thought, "Well, I'm not going anywhere." "Unga bukantihlu," he says, "don't look her in the eyes." And I look down, and this made it worse. The growling was deafening. "Tana anza akukatsongo," he says, "come back slowly." And I dragged my bum in the sand like that a little bit, and I noticed she started to calm. I said, "Oh, great, this is working perfect, huh?" He says, katongo, slowly. The slower I went, the more distance I got between us. Eventually, she went back.
Now,
he says, "He wants to tell you what really happened."
Alex,
he said, "The problem was Alex. He was a little bit arrogant. And he wasn't listening to me."
At 14, King and May.
And my problem, his problem, I hadn't trained Alex how to deal with big cats on foot. He wants to know from you, do you train your staff? Because if you don't, they're going to get eaten like Alex was. Almost eaten. Early the next morning, I get this bang on my door. Quang, 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 quang. It's a steel door. Quang, quang. And it's Renius. He says, "Hey, Alex, would you like to go for a bath?" 45 minutes later, the door bursts open like this. Quang! And his little boy, Nature, of 6 years of age, and his little girl, Angela, of about 12, he comes staggering into my bedroom like this massive zinc bath. "Heal me a bath, come away!" With piping hot water. Then they brought me a 20-liter canister of cold water so I could adjust the temperature. I have stayed at a few five-star places around the world, but the spirit of hospitality at that man's house was beyond anything I've ever experienced before. This was the ultimate form of giving, particularly when you consider the limited means from where it came from. And if there's one thing that Renius and I have learned is that productive relationships are built when you understand the life story of the person you are dealing with. But the time has come now for us to go beyond the cordial greetings, the politically correct greetings in the passageway, and to start listening to each other, and to start trying to understand each other. Because if you can get all of this right, you'll walk with the lions together.